was going nowhere. I was addicted to so many things. I'd lost all sense of purpose, all sense of pride. So I decided to ask for some help, which only took me 16 years to do, can you imagine? To say three words, "I need help," took 16 years. And when I did, I got sober and clean. And I have been ever since. And it was a real turning point in my life. I got my pride back. I started to think that I was a good person again. One of the things I felt guilty about was I didn't think I'd done enough to address the terrifying rise of the AIDS epidemic of the 1980s. So, from my huge entertainment in Atlanta, I set up the Elton John AIDS Foundation. Never in my wildest dreams could I have imagined how far it would grow and how far we would come in the treatment of HIV and AIDS. When I started the organization, people were dying right, left, and center. There was no hope. Now there is hope and there is medicine available. And I truly believe that in my lifetime, I hope that I will see the end to this pandemic. But we have a long way to go. There are still people suffering, even in America, in the poorer South. The epidemic is still there. So I'm going to double my efforts to make sure that we concentrate on that area and make sure that people have enough help and enough assistance to get the medicine and the help they require. And if one thing I've learned in my life is the extraordinary healing power of love and compassion. And I really believe that love is the true cure for what's wrong with the world, because when I did the concert for 9/11 in New York, people attended because they wanted to pay tribute to those that had fallen. And they didn't care what religion they were, they didn't care what color they were, or what political party they voted for. They were just there. We have become a divided race of people, not just here, but everywhere that I go. And I'd like to see, in the next year, people be a little kinder to each other. This song, Believe, is all about that. We'll be right back.